hearing that on the wall of the city, it was not just a wall around the old town, like around the city. It was a wall, a moat, another wall, another moat, and in some moats you had water. It was an important system. I will show you the oldest house of Geneva, which is almost 700 years old. Yeah, in front of me, you have a house with Gothic windows. You see, Gothic decorations above the windows. Huh? A typical medieval house. In this square, there are always people. And later in the afternoon, it will be crowded. It's the main square of the old town. If you look here, maybe you need to be more in front of me. On our right side, you can see the lake over there. We were down there before. From here, when I say that the old town was constructed on a hill, we understand very well. We see the is not old, from the 1950s, but it's different. The king won both with the good and bad. So, the two words. Swiss flag and the Geneva flag. The red and yellow one is the Geneva flag. The arms of Geneva, you have a bird, an eagle, because in the 11th century we call the origin of the construct this building at the end of the 12th century. First in the Romanist style, when you have round arches, round windows. Later in a Gothic style, when you have pointed arches. In front of us we have a late Gothic style. You see the windows became bigger just in front of us behind the tree in order to have more light inside. So this chapel was added to the main building later, in the beginning of the 15th century. Let's continue. So, a little question before. Who do you think used this building today, Protestants or Catholics?
Protestant.
Yes, you're right, sir. So, this building was constructed by Catholics. But when mass became forbidden, Protestants were not going to demolish Catholic buildings. You agree with me, huh? It was practical to keep them for them. So it was constructed by Catholics. Joking was saying that maybe God wasn't going to celebrate the Mass. And last year was that they were waiting for. Let's walk towards the main entrance. The main entrance is impressive because it has nothing to do with, again, have a look at these windows. The neoclassic was in fashion, so the entrance was demolished and we added this portico in a neoclassic style. Even when you stand in front, you see very well the two styles. Huh?
Thank you.
They destroyed the tower to do this entrance for both houses. And next to the old house, you have the arsenal, the old arsenal, the place where we it's no more possible. We have the archives of Geneva inside. But we kept these cannons to remind us that it was an arsenal. This cannon is good for all the arsenals. Three mosaic panels behind. Not very old, from the 1940s. But you see, three important moments for the history of Geneva. Please have a look. You see, Julius Caesar. So, let's continue with the history of Geneva. We became a little independent republic. We were a little country, Why did we decide to join Switzerland 200 years ago? 208 years ago.
Longest.
The border is at the foot of the
Thank you.
this block? You see the block where I'm pointing, not Fritter Luther. There's no statue. Although it's the most famous of these brothers in the history of these brothers that actually he was
he's going to for some people don't have enough to see.
Yeah. That's the reason he carry, because so many times we don't have enough.
We can switch off our which tours I'll continue. We'll continue the microphone on the bus.
Look at that. Nice. Oh, a broken chair. Fucking chair.
Yeah, I've seen it long time back. I think that's one of the nicest places.